Steve Dotto here. Glad you could join me today. Today we're going to take on Facebook cover photos. You know, those background photos and the foreground and your profile pictures too in Facebook. Really nice to go to a landing page on Facebook and see a nice cover photo that speaks to you. And so many of us are graphically challenged, and Facebook has all these special size requirements and how much text you're allowed and all sorts of things. So I went looking for a tool that would help me. The main reason I started looking for a tool is I've been taking a workshop on making my Dottotech Facebook page better. And if you visited it recently, you might notice it has significantly improved. I've been taking this workshop with Mary Smith. She's really got a nice handle on how to communicate, especially as a company and as a brand on Facebook. And the first thing she taught us in the course is, of course, to improve the look of our Facebook page. Now, I have to show you this because I'm kind of embarrassed, but this used to be the landing page or my cover photo in Facebook as I started the course. I had 1,000 followers or 1,000 likes and probably the ugliest Facebook cover photo on the planet. I had like a grainy version of part of my logo because I started working on it. I can remember starting to work on it, trying to figure it out, trying to get it to format, trying to get it to fit, and I failed miserably. So I just said, screw it. And that's what I went with for the longest time. But taking Mary's course taught me, okay, I really need to figure things out. So now I have changed my Facebook landing page on the Dottotech site to this. And let me just show you what it looks like now. So it used to look like that. And now if we scroll down there, there it is. So that's what it looks like now. So it much better represents the kind of fun that we have on the radio show and my own personality and that sort of stuff. So I think that we've done a good job on that. And I found a tool that helps. So I want to show you how I went about creating that sort of a page. So you can use it if you have a fan page or if you have a personal page. Now, I do need to make somewhat of a disclaimer. I am not going to tell you what looks good graphically and what doesn't look good graphically. You can tell by my particular layout technique that I am somewhat limited. I go for the collage because that's what I can do. But the tool that I'm going to show you allows your artistic talents to come to the fore. And there's a whole variety of these free tools out there now. This one, we'll put the link in the information link here in YouTube. But this one here allows us to create either fan pages, fan page covers, or personal profile cover pages. Now, I really don't know the difference between the two, other than one's on a fan page and one's on a personal page, but they seem to have the same basic layout and that sort of stuff. So I've already done my fan page one, so I'm going to show you how you can do all of the different things to create your own personal page. But if you have a fan page, the same tools work. Now, they allow us to deal with basically three elements. You can deal with your foreground picture, your profile picture that goes in a little square here, but we're all pretty comfortable with dealing with that now. Typically, we just put a logo or our one picture in, and it's all about cropping. And I'm not going to give you a cropping lesson for sure now. So you can just choose that photo. And if you want, you can put the one in. You can upload the photo that you use so you can see what it's going to look like as far as composition goes, or you can just wait later on and you can bring it in when you're actually in Facebook. Now, dealing with the actual the cover photo itself or the cover area itself, you have both a background and foreground images, and they allow you to basically crop and rotate images into that and then adjust the color and the saturation a little bit, as well add different graphical elements. So you can bring, basically you just assemble whatever you want into this window right here. So all you have to do is upload either a foreground or background image. So I'm going to upload a background image first to show you how that works. And I've got a little background here. I just went into my iPhoto library and I found kind of an out of focus picture of the view from our cabin at our lake that our family has in the Caribou. So I thought that might make a nice background photo. And as you can see, it's a little bit dark. It's really a crummy photo, but that kind of blurriness might work for a background. I don't know. Is my artsy side coming out? But you can adjust by sliding these things here. You can adjust the saturation and the color, the background brightness, the contrast. You can wash it out, make it really washed out like that sort of thing. So you can adjust the photo to suit your needs. Then you can choose other photos to bring in. Now, you might take a photo and you might in Photoshop or in another program, even just in Preview, you can remove the background from a photo if you just want to have your foreground image and you want to kind of be sit over top. So you can do all those sorts of things with your photos. That's the preparation work you do before you start assembling it in this sort of an application. But once you've done all of that, you can start uploading the photos to it. I'm just going to choose, let's choose me. When I was a kid going camping. There it is. so I can position that photo wherever I want. And I've got basic cropping tools and a size adjustment tool, so I can make it a little bit larger if I want. I could make it quite a bit bigger and then just have it kind of there in the corner. I can rotate it. If you're really artsy, you can start to spin the pictures and stuff like that. Always go back and click reset to set it back where it was. So you can adjust the composition of the picture and bring in as many different photos as you want, as many different elements as you want, and put them all together. So, okay, let's have another picture of me. Since we're on a roll, let's have me as, there we go, in costume. Is this turning into one of the best cover photos ever? But you can see that you can kind of go collage-y, or you can go nice background image with maybe just a little bit of text and a simple photo. You've got all of the different control to do those things. As well, you can put in very quickly and easily, you can add text here, and you can do those sorts of things, drawing in images or bringing in graphical elements, choosing which font you want. And it's got a limited number of fonts, of course, but you've got a few fonts to choose from. And then having stroke and fill color to kind of fill in and use your text, give your text different treatments. All of this is however much skill and however much time you want to bring. One of the things that's kind of nice about this, though, is it's really deals with the layers very simply, because what happens is I've got to choose the cursor. Because layering is so important as you set the different images in. So whatever one you click on last is the one that's most in the foreground. So when you go to actually export the photo, whatever one you've done last, you set your layers just by clicking and choosing kind of from back to front. And then once you finish that, you can export it. So when it's all said and done, what we do is we just go save timeline cover photo right here. And then it exports it as a PNG file for us that we can then upload into Facebook. And you already should know how to upload that into Facebook. The bottom line is it's really easy to compose a much more interesting, much more dynamic cover photo for either a fan page or for your own personal profile page. I hope you found this little tutorial useful. If you have, please give us a like. We appreciate the kudos. I'm Steve Dotto. Thanks for taking time to chat with me today.